pull over here and what little bit of shade there is, and we're gonna get the John boat out. We got a ton of stuff to show you that we got for it over the last 4 months or so. We found some things on eBay and some things on Amazon you might find pretty interesting if you're gonna fix up a John boat.
Hey, what we've done to her so far. I flipped her over and we sanded down the bottom and we repainted the bottom and we repainted the sides, and it's just standard green aluminum John boat paint, and you can find that on Amazon. The inside now, what you're looking at on the inside, I'm going to tell you about. This is, look at them bees. This stuff on the inside that I done is this. It's the dark olive Duplicolor bed armor. And that's three coats, three cans on the inside. I was going to carpet all this, but instead I done this. So I got one more can left. I'm going to touch it up. But it has to sit out here in the sun, and it'll actually darken up to this color green. When you first spray it on, it's light brown, but it will darken to green because I put one coat, stuck it out in the sun, waited to turn to green, and now it's the second coat, and I got one more coat to do. So that's the bed armor. Now I'm going to put the floor in. I'm going to put the plyboard, but I think I might seal the plyboard two different ways. I might use a sealer on it, but then again, back here on the transom, I sanded down this transom, put all new bolts in it, and I fiberglassed that whole transom. That thing will last 20 some years, it'll last my lifetime. And then I put all new bolts in the back of the transom here and done the same thing. Sealed those over. You can still tighten up the bolts on this side, they will not move. I sealed it with that, it's the Bondo glass, and it's made for boats, and it works well on metal, wood, aluminum, pretty much anything if you got a good surface, if you prep your surface right. And so I used about a half a can on that. It's like $20, get it at AutoZone. So that transom, number one, is never going to, it started to crack a little bit, and rather me cutting a new piece of board, and I just put all new bolts in it and sealed it with fiberglass. So that's going to be good. Nothing's going to happen to that. And I wanted a little texture on it so that new trolling motor I'm going to show you doesn't move any. So that's what we did to the backside. Now on the seats, I don't know if you remember, they were red, but they were really faded. So we got the red Rust-Oleum Ultra Cover paint and primer, bonds to plastic, and believe it or not, it is flexible. Of course, I had crap on my hands. It'll still allow the, I still gotta go over it just a tiny bit, but it doesn't look too bad. So we're gonna finish this coat on this one and let it bake in the sun today, but I'm gonna set up a table and I'm gonna show you some of the things I found off of Amazon and what kind of mods we're gonna do to this John boat. Oh, and I was talking about the plyboard. Let me show you something about the fiberglass. I used this board here to mix fiberglass on when I was doing that transom there. But you can take a plyboard, chipboard, any type of board, and you can take that Bondo glass and you can coat it. This was just a piece I was using to mix it up and do that transom. You can coat it and it will become waterproof. If you seal the whole board and then you can put your carpet over that, or you can use a marine sealer if you like. But I think what I'm going to do is, I still have to go get the plyboard. I'm gonna cut my plyboard, make sure I fit it, and then we're going to Bondo glass the plywood before I put the little carpet on it. What we got here is you got to have a throw. The wind's blowing, so hopefully the audio ain't distorted. It's really blowing now. You got to have a throw ring or float. So instead of me getting that little cushion thing that if you have to throw it, it ain't gonna save anybody, I went to Target's and I got this one, and I can transfer it to all the boats when I go out, because by Virginia law, you gotta have a throw float. You also have to have a first aid kit and emergency sign. So that come out of a road kit I had. And you also have to have a fire extinguisher. So we got one of those as well. I'll put the link up for that buoy. I got some ropes, tie ropes. Got some of those off of Amazon. I got a hummingbird fish finder used off of eBay. I'm going to put a tower on it as well with a little bimini top, you'll see. And on the top of that, I'm going to put these. They were 20 bucks. I want to tell you what, they're hard metal. They're plastic, they're metal on ends, and no, it's all metal. They are bright as heck. I hooked them up. These are spots that's going to go on the tower. So I got two of those for 19 bucks. I'll put the link up for that. I also got this little thing here. It's got a USB. I think this might have came from China and only took 2 weeks. It wasn't nothing. It's got a 12-volt cigarette lighter plug. It's got a USB charger. And it also has, tells you how many voltage, what's your charge left on your battery. So that's going to go on the tower. It's like, I think, I hate to say, I think it was like $6, but I don't remember. I'll put that link up. We got a couple oar holders because you never know when you're going to need them. I found those on eBay for this boat. It was actually for this one, so I lucked out there. Because some of them are too long, some of them are too short to fit in that factory oar holder. I got two sump pumps, both of them off of eBay. This one's a whole kit with the hose and the side thing. And I had bought this one first, and then I got this one. I'm going to put, I think, this one in. This one's going to go in the Sunbird boat. This little kit was pretty cheap, and it has the, sump pump? Bilge pump. It has the little bilge pump here, 600 gallons per minute to track. That one's a Tsunami. I think this is going to go in the drum or the Sunbird boat, and I'm going to use this one on the drum boat. I don't think I need too much overkill, but you never know. I had some hose wraps, or some hose wraps, some wire covers from Lowe's, Home Depot. I got these four rod holders, and I wanted this type. And we're probably going to put them, I'm probably going to make a bracket for them and put them on the boat somewhere. I haven't figured out where I'm going to put them. I was going to put them here, but I don't think I'm going to do that now. So we'll figure out where we're going to put these rod holders. I got a new bilge plug. I got a rope holder. I got some LED lights that's going to go on the tower facing down with switches. They are the LED strip lights. They're white. They're bright as heck. You can get them in any color. And they're 12 volt. I got four of those. They're going to face down in the boat. There's my front light and my back light. Because I'm definitely going to use this at night. When I put the tower on, I found these old, really nice rocket launchers. They're old, but I really like them. Clean them up a little bit. They're going to go on the tower facing back so I can do some trolling. I got a horn for it, electric horn. Why? Because I can. Because if anybody comes even close to me in this drum boat, within 25 yards, they're going to get a blast from my horn. That ought to be pretty funny. And it had a switch too, I think. Switch done fell out in that box, I believe. Got the bottom piece for mounting the, I got two of them. This one, front one, comes with its own piece, so I'm going to sink it down in that front. And then that I'm going to sink in the corner. I'm going to make a little wooden bracket holding type of thing in that corner to hold this, the back one. This, I told you, I showed you a video. It's called Rod Holder Camera Mount. And this is going to be mounted on a boat. And I can probably on the back, so I can hook a camera to it and you can tilt it and it extends way out. So that's going to be for my camera mount. I probably put it on the front facing back. Couple more cleats, but I got all them cleats off that salvage boat down there. Let me show those to you. Let's see what those cleats look like. So I got all these cleats. I had ordered these little plastic ones, but you know what? I think I might use the other ones instead. I don't think those little plastic ones are going to do squat. So I'm going to put those, I got four of those. I'm going to put those on the John boat. That's a salvage from that salvage boat. So there's the cleats. I got this 55 pound thrust trolling motor off of the eBay, brand spanking new. I've tried it, it does work. I had to put the propeller on it. It's a three blade, and I got that, and I'm going to take the 36 pound off, so we should be able to move this thing a little bit with that trolling motor. Now the thing I want to show you is these rails. I got these rails off the net for the sides. Now you can't really buy side rails for John boats anywhere. I haven't found them. Probably at a marine supply somewhere they make them. But I'm going to show you what I got here. If I can get her open. I taped it shut. I taped that shut. It was stapled. All right. These are going to be the rails. Now what I'm going to do is they come with brackets. What this is this is for a motor home. This is for the top of a motor home. And what we're going to do, this is the luggage rack for our RV. Set it there a second and get the end piece. You got to cut it. I'll put the link up for that, but I got to cut it and angle it. I'm going to have a rail around it. Just makes things a little easier to grab a hold on to and hold on when the waves are rough. And so we're going to put that on. We got to do the other side and cut it and bend it. We'll have to bend it into shape. So it was $60. $60, and it's a universal motorhome, luggage rack from Topline, and that's from Paramount, California. I don't see their website on there.
Good. I got this middle support pop riveted. I got this little piece bent just a slightly. I'm going to have to cut that there, so I'm going to have to mark it. And then I need to bend the other side. How I bent it was, I stuck it down in the top of this thing and just bent it slightly so that the angle, I'll show you on the other one.
Here, see how it was going that way? And it needed to go this way just a little bit. So I put it in here. You don't can't do too much, you'll break it. Just a tiny bit more. It's better than a vise, actually. See that? Now when I put it on this side, it's going to be perfect. So let me cut. I got to cut and measure. I got to put my brackets. And I pop rivet them in. I just drilled a hole. And pop rivet them. You know how to do pop rivets. Let's see how that does. Let's see here. Need to go down a little farther because I want to go in just a tiny bit. So, need to bend it just a little bit more. Once I get one measured, then I can do the others to match it. So I got them bent. And slide two on each side. I had to do some fine tuning on that one. See how the corner's not quite bent down. That's even now. Okay, so we're gonna drill and we're gonna pop rivet. I took that much off. I just put it in a vise and backed it off with a hacksaw. There it is. Only thing I gotta do is secure. I'm still gonna have to touch up my little paint. Is secure the back ends and then put the pop rivets in where the screws were. But I like it. I still can't get over how good that turned out. I did put a smaller pipe in between the two. Where is it? I had a little pipe. Here it is. I had a little piece of pipe that was the same as the inside diameter. So I cut it and it goes from here to here to just add some strength. And when I drill these through here and put these rivets, it'll be pretty good. So, I mean, this would have held it, but now it's a piece solid all the way through there. So, it was just off of an old clothing hanger rack, drying little thing to hold shirts on for the laundry room.
Went out where those screws were.
I'm going to put pop rivets in there. A couple smaller pop rivets. So, put them in there. This one's right through where those pipes meet, so I gotta put this big one in there. See if I can't get it in there. It's an extra long pop rivet. If you gotta go through two pieces of metal. See that? That whole side's done. And that thing is it's sturdier than those rails on the big boats. So we got them pop riveted in the bottom. Pop riveted in here. Four in there. There she be. Thought I'd finish before dark.